Hi, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Kelly, and this is Kelly Bell Stitches. Happy New Year. This is the first update video of 2017. I did the tag that Jesse Marie and some other people made questions up for as my first video, and that was my previous video. Mm, 2017. It's pretty cold here in New York today. Yesterday it was 2 below 0 when I went out to have blood work done. Today at least it was 13 degrees, so I guess we're in a heat wave. Unlike Texas, who had snow and it melted and went back up to 70s and 80s. We're not that lucky. Anyway, I wanted to do a normal like WIP update and share some stuff that I've started and maybe even show you one of my embroidery books. I may show you some embroidery books now in a few videos going forward because I was cleaning some stuff out and came across some old stuff that I may just pick up again and try. And I'll show you something not stitchy related that I'm also working on during this last week and for this month. The first thing I think I'm going to do is a WIP update. Let's see. I have them all over the place. I'm surrounded by stuff. It's a little disconcerting. My clock's gonna chime. Yep. Yay. It's only on the half hour, so at least I'm only hearing one. I'll start with my Princess and the Unicorn, which is out of this cross-stitch myth and magic book. Really a cool book. Lots of designers. This one is designed by Susan Penny. And it is, let's see if I can turn it around and show it to you. It is the, I think it's, is it Princess and the Lady? Yes, Princess and the Unicorn. And that was one of my starts later in 2016. And I haven't really gotten much further than I was the last time I showed it. Just moving a needle. But this is a piece of 18 count Aida that I dyed myself. And you can see I'm still working on the unicorn, and the purple just moves up into the reins and a little bit into the princess's clothes. But it's a nice kind of, I'm gonna make it a stormy picture. It's on a lighter colored fabric in the actual pattern or book. And I just thought it would look kind of cool. A little bit stormier. And then, Joan Elliott. There's a tour de designer going on Stitch Mania, and I've been working on this, I think it's called a dancing unicorn, but that's what it looks like. I know it seems like I have a unicorn thing, but I really don't. But that just happens to be the one I started, was this dancing unicorn. And I really don't think this has gotten much further than the last time I showed it either. And it's also on another piece of that same, move the threads, same fabrics that I showed before. And you really can't make much out here. Just the unicorn and some of the reins. But that's Joan Elliott, who is the designer this month for Stitch Mania, or this, I don't know, might be a quarter, I'm not sure. And let's see, what else? All right. Oh, and that was out of, I'm sorry, that Joan Elliott's out of this Bewitching cross-stitch book. And it's a Joan Elliott book. And then I have another whip that is out of the Ultimate Cross Stitch book, and it is the most current one, volume 11, 2016. And there's no final picture. On page 107, it has, I'll hold it back, it has a bunch of these elves, you know, sprites. And I'm doing this one with the mushrooms and the stockings. And I'll show you where I am with that one. Maybe if I can get the bag open. Not much to show on that either. But you got the little elf legs and some of the snow cover on the ground and then a stocking or two. But I'm having fun with that. And that's on a 14 count opalescent Ada, which is fun. And then I think the last whip I worked on actually I worked on it on January 5th, 6th, and 7th was my Hade that I'm doing. Open. Oh, I can't. It's taped in. I have to show you this way. Sorry about the glare. It's called In the Garden Shed, and you can see it's a beautiful garden shed. And excuse me, phone call. I'll take care of that. Hold on. Always happens. Nobody ever calls me until I'm doing something else. Sorry. And I'm going to try not to edit too much. So anyway, this is In the Garden Shed, and it's cats and kind of a messy garden shed. And since we love gardening and we love cats, I have five cats, I thought that, and it's a Hade, Heaven and Earth design. And it's huge. It's like a 50 or 60 page pattern chart. And that's where I am. It's the very top corner, and it's one pot up in the corner. And there's a whole lot of different colors in there. It's kind of, as usual, kind of confetti heavy. But I'm really enjoying it, and it's on the Magic Guide cloth, and that makes it really good. And believe it or not, I've been stitching it in hand because I can't figure out. I've tried it on Q-snaps, I've tried it on scroll rods, and it is so big that I'm not comfortable with it. So now I fold it up and I just hold the fabric up and I'm stitching on in hand. And I'm going to go on like that until it becomes too wieldy to hold. So that's my plan with that. And I have notes here. It's a new journal I bought, and I bought it at Walmart's yesterday, believe it or not. And it's a weekly and monthly planner. And it's actually not too bad. It has tabs for monthly and weekly, and it has addresses, and it's not numbered or dated, so it's all blank. So if I stop using it, I can pick it up whenever I want. And I've decided to use this for kind of just when I'm doing any particular work, because I don't usually do that. I usually go by memory. So on the I started a couple of sales this year. My first ever monthly sales, mystery sales. I've never done those before, so it's a new venture for me, and I've actually started two of them. The first one I started was the Birthstone Dragon Sale. And hang on. Let's see if I can come up with the first page of that, because it's just a picture. There it is. And that's what it looks like for January. It's the border, and then it's the Garnet Dragon. And I started that on January 1st. It was my new start from the new year. And I'm working on the border. And I worked on it the first, the second, the third, and the fourth. So let's see. Figure out what the top is. Here's the top. And this is on 28 count Joblin that I ice dyed myself. So, and that's what that looks like. And I am not using a metallic for the border. I'm actually using a variegated DMC floss, and that's 4073. And I'm really liking it. I don't use a lot of variegated DMC, but that's what that looks like. And I think it's actually looking pretty good. It kind of looks like kind of gleaming gold, like where sun's passing over it. So yeah, I'm liking that. And this is a white opal 28 count. And I think I got it at 123 stitch. And I'm really enjoying that. It's stitching up really, really good. So far, so good. And then, I know I'm going through this kind of fast. Sorry. The second one I started is the Lakeside Needlecraft Under the Sea Mystery Sal. And you can see there's January's release, and it's that really cute octopus. And this is another one that I wasn't too sure of when I started, but I'm really enjoying it, really liking it a lot. And believe it or not, for a person who just said in a previous my previous video that I don't like linen, that I prefer Aida, my last mystery sow was on 28 count Joblin. And this one is on a 30 count linen that is called Seafoam, and it's a Weeks Dye Works fabric. And that's what that looks like so far. And yeah, I am really enjoying it. It doesn't have a border. There's no border in this one. So I am just working on, and you can probably see it there, I'm working on the octopus. So I'm liking it. And this linen is actually stitching up really well. I do like this Weeks Dye Works Seafoam. Very pretty. I had thought about over dyeing it with some blue to make it more oceany, but I think the seafoam green is going to be really nice. So that's the other mystery sow that I'm doing. And let's see. Oh, one more thing. I am participating in the cross stitch finish line round robin. Joanne Perry is being good enough to kind of coordinate it. She said she's not participating in it, but she's coordinating it, and she is doing a fabulous job. She has been so good. Anyway, so what this is there's six people in a team, and we each come up with a design that we want to work, and we start it, pick our own fabric. This is a group A, and it's any fabric. So we pick a fabric, then we start the design, and then we pass it to a person who in turn stitches on it and passes it to the next person. So at that same time, other people's pieces are coming around through me. And the way Joanne has it all set up is you always mail it to the same person. So it makes it easy. You only have one address to mail to. And then in the end, you get your piece back, and then you can do whatever finishing still needs to be done. So this kind of goes into some haul that I got. So I'll show you the piece first. And my, I didn't pick a pattern. So a lot of people picked patterns, and they'll be passing the pattern, and then the pattern will be destroyed after you do your part. But for mine, I want to do a tea theme. So for mine, it could be cups, sweets, cakes, time, Alice in Wonderland related for the tea party, that kind of thing. And I want people to use their imaginations. And I'm providing a little write-up, and I'm also sending a list of the floss colors that I've already used. And any people are supposed to provide their own DMC, but any specialty fibers you're supposed to send with your package. And the only thing I've used that's special for the part I did is the 202HL Krennic. And so I'm sending a couple of spools of that just in case anybody wants to add it. And so this is the central motif that I've done for my tea time sampler. And I love it. I think that it came out just beautifully. And it's like a mandala center. And yeah, and the Krennic gives it a nice sparkle, but I don't know if you can see in this terrible lighting. But I really like it. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna section it off into quadrants for people to stitch, or if I'm gonna have people decide what quadrant they wanna stitch in as they go. I mean, I have a few ideas for things when it comes back to me, but it's all going to depend on what people elect to stitch. So it's a bit of a gamble, but I'm hopeful. And so that leads into a piece of my haul. Now I am doing a stitch from stash, and I've ordered a lot of things before it started, and I am waiting for some things to come in. But I also have a few things, so I thought I would show you. And I did get a couple of gift certificates for Christmas, so that'll be good. But anyway, I want to show you this. This is RYO Mandala Set 7 by Ink Circles. Now, I don't have the rest of these. I just have Set 7, but it's really cool. And I think the one I did is something like this one. I use that for inspiration. It has some color guide, you know, some thoughts on color selection inside the pattern, and a few ideas. And it kind of gets you set up so you can get started on your own. And I really like the way my central motif, have to get it around to top, because see, I stitched a little word in gold top here so I would know which end was up, which I don't always, but that's the central motif. And then this is the one that I used for inspiration right there. So yeah, I thought that was a lot of fun, and I'm really glad I got this because it opens up a lot of possibilities. Okay, so also from Heaven and Earth Designs, Michelle has started selling bulk needles, tapestry needles. And so I bought, these are John James 28s, and there's 100 of them in the package. So 28s are a little bit, I usually do 26s, but I think the 28s are going to be fine. And she did have 26s. For some reason, I ordered 28s. And I don't think I showed this before. Maybe I did. I can't remember. But this is Jardine Privé, and it's Quaker de Noël. And I just love that. I thought that was really beautiful. And it's done with two colors, I think. And I was thinking that this would be really kind of cool in a colorless colored way. And then I also ordered, and excuse me if I've already shown some of this, I may have. I ordered Long Dog Samplers Castles in the Air. I love castles and dragons, and this is just too cool. It says, dream a little dream with me. And I love it. There's not much else I can say about that. I love it. And then I couldn't resist this. I did get the names of God previously. And my big toe has got so many wonderful spiritual inspirational charts. And when my husband passed away, actually it'll be his hemorrhagic stroke happened on January 11th, 2009. So the anniversary of that's tomorrow. And his date of death was the 12th. So when this happened and I was going through grief counseling and stuff, this blessing calmed me. I said this all the time to myself. And it's called the Lord Bless You here. And it's the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Because at the time, peace was really all I was looking for. And so I thought stitching this would be a very welcome thing. So I'm looking forward to that. That's really beautiful. So thank you, my big toe. And then on a lighter side, I bought the Jolly Santa Welcome, which is Amar Nick Designs, which is Santa and reindeer and welcome. And I don't know, I'm hoping I didn't show these before, but there are times my brain fails me. These are some of my penny books, and this is Charted Peasant Designs from Saxon, Transylvania. And I couldn't resist that. You can see the Saxony quality of it. And there are a lot of plates in the book that show some old world knit stitching, which is hard to see because it's very dark. But Saxony, Transylvania. I mean, I'll hold this back because it's the charts, but those are kind of cool. So I got that. And some of these books I'll never stitch out of, but they're fun to look at. And then I got 101 Folk Art Designs for Canada Cross Stitch and Other Needlecrafts. And that's this one. And it's a paperback. I mean, it was Goodwill and it's labeled 99 cents. So I paid a penny plus $3.99 shipping, but to me it was worth it. And Goodwill made a little extra money. And it's actually a Dover book. And I love Dover. They have some really great books. And that's the types of charts that are in this book. So that all makes me very happy. So you can see some of the things that I have on my plate as far as cross stitching goes. And then I want to share another thing I'm working on. I can just remember where I put it. Well, first I'll show you my book. This is old. I bought this book brand new way back when. It's called Creative Cruel Embroidery. It's a Lark book, and it has, I think, a copyright of 1998. So, Creative Cruel Embroidery, and it's Judy Jeroy, and I'm not going to do a flip through. I mean, if anybody wants a flip through, I would be more than happy to, but, you know, like every good book, it starts out with tools and techniques, and it's yarn and thread and fabric and needles, and it goes into, you know, techniques of different stitches. And let's see if I can find a picture of the kind of work that we're talking when this is cruel. Oh, here it is. So that's kind of what cruel embroidery looks like. It's painting a picture with floss and different stitches. And this is old. I mean, this is ancient. I know I did this back in the 90s, and it's probably the only piece of crewel work I did. And I call it Jacobian needlework. But you can see here, I did the leaves on the branch, and there's beads for the grapevine, and there's the bird, and a leaf with different designs, and more beading and stitch work below it. Let's see. So, and I had a lot of fun doing that. So, I may have to do some more of that. That was fun. And then the other thing that I've been working on, I started this around the 5th, and I have to have it ready to mail out by February 3rd, I think. It's actually due to be finished, and pictures have to be posted by the 31st. And this is just the guts. It's going to have a spiral binding from my cinch, and I'm going to have to divide the pages because the cinch is a ringed binding, like a notebook. A spiral notebook. But then these are all the guts. You create the pages, you know, you color, stain, dye the pages, and then you add cutouts and postcards, and you make, to put this down. So then I have a like a Snow White here, and it's a double pocket to hold, you know, extra paper or tags. So that's the junk journal I'm working on. My Mickey ears down here, which is actually also like a tuck spot where it'll hold additional paper. So that's another thing that I really enjoy doing. And that group on Facebook is called Junk Journal Junkies. So lots of fun there too. I think I've actually signed up for 4 journals in the next few months, so that's going to be fun. I know I have birds and butterflies, paper dolls, and Jane Austen still to do.
Sorry, drop
so
frame.
So yeah, I think that's about it. My cold is hanging in here, but it's getting better. I'm starting to get used to my preventative medicine for my migraines. And so things are good here, a little cold, but other than that, everybody's happy and healthy. The dogs are doing good. I was watching Stitcherista before I started filming this, and I just want to say that my prayers are with you. I'm sorry that you got bad news, but don't let that knock you down. Stand back up and keep looking up. Things will get better. You have to believe that. And if you need anything, we have a huge community here. And if you need me, I'm available. And so with that, I am going to end. I hope that everyone's staying warm or cool, as the need may be. And until next time, happy stitching.